just one of those things. Just one of those crazy flings. One of those bells that now and then ring.
Whoa, the man, the legend, Francis Albert Sinatra singing. Just one of those things from the Capitol album, Swing Easy. I gotta give you a little bit more of those, folks. It's fantastic.
Just one of those fabulous flights. A trip to the moon.
The one, the only, Francis Albert Sinatra, man. It doesn't get better than that. And you know what time it is. This is another RSR. Video email bag show, and just in case you're living under a rock or you forgot who I was, forget about it. I'm the man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing. Forget about it. And this is the bag you've been waiting for. I tell you what, I come home, I get home, I walk in the door, go check my email, walk in my home office, and forget about it. I got more questions. Excuse me, but that's okay. Because that's what I'm here for. I told you I never cherry pick. Unlike Floyd, make it rain, Mayweather Jr. We don't cherry pick here. We answer them all. And we got some doozies tonight. But before I begin, if you want to be on my next show, send your questions in too. Excuse me, I think the cold is getting to me and it wasn't that cold today. Send your questions in to ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. Again, that's ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. Now, if you want to sponsor or advertise on the RSR video email bag show, send serious business inquiries to, come on, you know the email address, but I'll give it to you again, ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. Now, for those of you who've asked, yes, this is the book. We plug it every time because it seems that there's a lot of talk about it, and I tell you what, that warms my heart. I can't appreciate you enough for picking it up, sharing it, reviews, pictures, and so on. Boxing Interviews of a Lifetime by, as I always say, the cat on the back. Now, if you want to pick up my book, go to authorhouse.com. Again, that's authorhouse.com. Now, without further ado, let's get into these great questions. Are you ready? Let's do it. First question. Bad Brad, on behalf of our boxing group here in England, we salute you, sir. We literally have parties around both your interview show and email bags, cracking us up, and we discuss boxing. Never, never stop. Well, thank you. That's a great compliment. I truly appreciate that, pal. The queen sends her love. Okay, the queen sends her love. Well, I send my love back to the queen, and I'll throw in a forget about it to the queen as well. All right, queen, forget about it. And he goes on to say, I want to ask you about this creep Antonio Margarito, who I heard is being allowed to fight again. What are your thoughts? I already know you'll pull zero punches, and the gang is standing by to hit play. Thanks so much, Noel J., London, England. Well, Noel J., again, thank you for that great compliment. I truly appreciate it. Forget about it. And to the queen, a double forget about it. And to all the royal family, forget about it. Antonio MargaCHEATER. Oh, you're gonna get it from me on this one. He's a freaking scumbag. Why do I say that? Because I don't like to call names, but he is. Why? Because he's a freaking cheater. Okay? What he did to Miguel Cotto, a boxing fan or a lover of the sport or a lover of humanity itself, would kick his ass. Okay? Took the gauze out, took the stuffing out of his gloves. It looked like Miguel went through a windshield at 90 miles an hour. I'm sure you remember that. And then Shane Mosley's camp caught him. Then Shane commenced putting that beat down on his ass. He gets suspended for a year, if you recall. But Bobby Boy Arum, who ain't no freaking good either, okay? I said it. Go back and tell him I said it. He's an embarrassment. I don't care how great of a promoter he is. He's dirty. He knows it. It's ridiculous. You want to know how dirty he is? Go watch the documentary on Luis Resto and Panama scumbag Luis about the Irish Billy Collins, Luis Resto fiasco, okay? Horrible, horrible what they did. But Bobby Boy was against that. But when it came time, he was against Luis Resto. But when it came time for Antonio MargaCHEATER to be up his 1 year suspension, what does Bobby Boy do? He throws him in with his cash cow, Manny Machado's Pacquiao, for a big payday. So you cheat and you get freaking rewarded for it. I don't believe in that. Oh, we got a telemarketer. Let me see real quick. Yes, we do. And we're hanging up on him because that's the way we do things here in the RSR office. We don't accept calls from telemarketers. All right, forget about it. Anyways, back to Bobby Boy Arum and Antonio MargaCHEATER. So he comes back. He gets the prize against Arum's golden goose, Manny. My shoulders, Pacquiao. Okay, he should have been banned from boxing for life. Okay, banned. Luis Resto went to prison. Did he not? Right or wrong? Sure did. He's a scumbag. It disgusts me. Mexico, of course, is where he's going to fight. Mexico, of all places. He should not be sanctioned anywhere in the world, and this is why we need unified rules and a unified body in boxing to stop this bullshit from happening, because he doesn't deserve to fight. He cheated. I don't care if he's a great guy now. I don't care. He could have killed Cotto, which he damn near did. He could have killed somebody else. He's a freaking cheater. I despise cheaters. Never let him back in boxing if it was up to me. All right, Noel J. from London, England. I told you, I pull no freaking punches. You see, I'm getting a little bit verklempt over this for my viewers out there. All right, next question. Bad Brad, enjoy the show very much, especially when you go old school. I like Triple G, but I'm so tired of hearing he's the next Marvin Hagler. He couldn't shave Marvin's head before a hamshoe fight. What do you think? Excuse me. From Franco, Tulsa, Oklahoma. Well, Franco from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Forget about it. Was it not a beautiful day today? It was in the 60s. Eat your heart out, East Coast. What was it over there in the 20s? Anyways, I like Triple G too. I'm not 100% sold on him, but I think he's a great fighter. I like that he fights quite often. Okay, I know he's having a hard time securing a super fight. I know all the bullshit going on between him and Canelo. Come down to 152.241.615, whatever the frick Canelo wants, which is ridiculous. Fight him at the weight that you should fight him at. Middleweight, 160. Forget all these catchweights. No, he's not Marvin Hagler. And let's just call it like it is. Marvelous Marvin Hagler, who I actually had the privilege of meeting in Taormina, which is in Italy, at a resort club back in 1991. I was stationed in Sigonella, Sicily at the time. Was introduced to Marvin Hagler, spent half the night talking about boxing. Fantastic guy. Could go. One day I'll tell the story. If you want to hear it, write in, and I'll tell you the story in one of the bags. It'll take a while, though. Anyways, there was only one Marvelous Marvin Hagler. There will never be another Marvelous Marvin Hagler. So the comparison is like saying Harry Connick Jr., who I like, and Michael Bublé, who I kind of like, is the next Sinatra. Are you freaking kidding me? There'll never be another Francis Albert Sinatra. There is only one. Sounds like Highlander, right? Forget about it. But Triple G is a great fighter. He has not got that career-defining fight. I've said that many times. But no, he's not. It's not even fair to compare him to Marvin Hagler. Different level of competition, though I don't blame a fighter for the level of competition they have in their era that they must face. However, they must face the best of their generation. What isn't fair is when you say, well, you know, Hagler had all these great fighters, or Ali had all these great fighters, and then compare Deontay Wilder and these other champions, lower weight champions. They don't have the level of opposition that they do, but yet they still need to fight the best. And my verdict is not completely set in stone yet on Triple G. I do like him. I think he's exciting. I love his body work, but he will never be Marvin Hagler, period. All right? So I understand what you're saying, and that was pretty funny. Shave his head before a Hampshire fight. And if anybody doesn't know who Hampshire is, we're talking about Mustafa Hampshire. Interviewed him a couple years back, and he fought Marvin Hagler twice. Last question. Bad Brad, it's your blue Jew. Oh, geez, I'm going to start right there, my blue Jew. All right, I already know who this is, folks. It's going to be a little crazy. Stand by for it. I'm sure it's going to be something funny. Bad Brad, it's your blue Jew, back with a New Year rhyme just for you. Oh, jeez. I see you standing there naked. Oh, forget about it. With just your fedora. You open the door and say, forget about it, melt me in two. Then I really become a blue Jew because I wake to find it was all just in my mind. Oh, my God. She's a poet and she don't even know it. All right. But hey, a Jewish girl can dream and would like to kiss you like a ball of strawberry ice cream. Oh, I told you she's off the chain tonight. Did you like my rhyme, Mr. Forget About It Man? Actually, I'm going to say it before the end of the thing. Janice from the Bronx. Of course I liked your rhyme, bubby. You crack me up every time. You and your father, happy new year to you. You keep me in stitches, forget about it. She goes on to say, okay, boxing question for you. How do you think Rocky Marciano would fare in the land of giants today in heavyweight division? Hugs and kisses, Janice F. from the Bronx, New York. Janice F. Bubala. Oh, you crack me up, darling. Oy vey. As Packy Boom Boom Goldstein says, oy vey to the third power. Forget about it. All right. That's a good question. Because everybody says he was too small. He was under 200 pounds. That's true. He was short for a heavyweight. He was under 200 pounds. True enough. So was Joe Louis. True enough. But you want to know something? Rocky Marciano had a chin. He had heart. He had determination. He may take 4, 5, 6, and you may bust, put his nose over here. Or you may bust his lip open or close his eye. But he was coming. And a lot of fighters today, they don't have that tangible, and it's called heart. They get hit. They get dropped. They look for the door. Rocky Marciano didn't do that. He didn't do that. So, I'm thinking he goes to the body quite a bit. He brings that head down. He fights tall. And he's going to have to get over the size advantage, of course. And there's going to be a big weight advantage. But, man, The Rock could punch. And the punch can be the equalizer, height and weight and all that stuff. Okay? He still was close to 200 pounds. So he's punching with that type of power. Granted, these guys are 20, 25, 30 pounds heavier than him. That could make a difference. And the height, of course, 6'7", it's, you know, it's a big, big difference. But, hey. I know Primo Carnero wasn't all that, but did Joe Louis not chop him down? Did other fighters not chop him down? Yes, they did. So, Rocky Marciano was a special kind of fighter. Comes along once in a lifetime. Is he the greatest that ever lived? No, I know his record's 49-0. He's not the greatest that ever lived. He's not even the best heavyweight that ever lived. But he was special. And that tangible of determination and grit and heart, you can't teach those things. They're either instilled in you when you get in the boxing at the beginning, or they're not. Can you imagine Vladimir Klitschko? He'd be scared to death of Rocky Marciano. Now I know people are going to say, yeah, right, bad Brad, you're crazy. No, he would be. And Rocky didn't talk smack. He was a very humble man. But his these did all the talking. Like Ernie Shavers. Now Ernie Shavers came along a different era. But he scared people to death. But I think he could be competitive. And I think that he could beat a lot of the heavyweights out there. Of course, that's a what if, and it's all subjective. Because we know that Rocky Marciano was gone, and we know he'll never fight in this era. But he was special nonetheless. All right, Janice, my blue Jew from the Bronx, New York. Happy New Year again to you. All right, folks, that's another RSR video email bag show in the can, as we always say. And as Frank Sinatra sang so eloquently, so long ago, the best is yet to come. Bad Brad out.